Hey, this is Stern Effects. My name is Eran, and this time we're going to give some love to the preview panel inside After Effects. In this part of the Speed Up After Effects series, I want to show you how you can get faster and longer previews. So to demonstrate this, I will be using this composition that I created out of a multi-layered Photoshop file with few solids and adjustment layers, and there are some effects applied to them. There are also a couple of lights and animated camera in the scene. In short, there's a lot going on here. So it will take time for After Effects to cache this comp in full res, even with the new multi-frame rendering and speculative preview switched on. So if you need a quicker and more responsive result, there are a few things that you can do using the preview panel. But before we are going to get there, we need to do some housekeeping and define few keyboard shortcuts. And to illustrate it, I'll first switch off the cache frames when ideal under the composition menu, preview options. I'll also clear the current cache by going to the edit menu. And from here, I'm going to choose purge all memory and disk cache. Now, because I want to repeat this number throughout this tutorial, I'm going to go to the keyboard shortcut menu and search for the word purge. This is going to show me the two default shortcuts here on the Mac, which are Control plus clear, or the option Command and forward slash. Both are working only on the numbers keypad. So if you don't have access to an extended keyboard or you're using Windows, you may need to define a combination that works for you. But I'm going to use this shortcut to clear the green bar cache after I'll show you each option so we can start from scratch and compare the speed between each one of them. But before going there, and I know it is a very long buildup, I want to show you a few things inside the previews preferences of After Effects. So I'll go to the After Effects menu. On the PC side, of course, it's under the Edit menu, and I'll choose Settings, Previews. Over here, I'm going to change the adaptive resolution limit to, let's say, a quarter. And I'm going to talk about the other stuff in the next episode in this series. But for now, what I would like to do is just mute the audio when the preview is not real time. I can also determine the amount of seconds when I need to use the cache frames when idle, although in this case, I just switched it off. Okay, so I'm just going to click OK over here. And because I have an audio file, I just want to show you how you can change the preview settings for the audio. The first thing that you can do is you can press and hold the Command key here on the Mac. This will be the Control on the Windows side. And this means that if I'm going to move my current time indicator, After Effects is going to play a digital scrub of the audio. Now, if you don't find this too useful, you can select the clip and double tap the letter L. So LL in sequence is going to show you the waveform of the audio. And then you can park your cursor above something that you want to hear, and then hold and press the left button mouse and then add the Command or Control key, and After Effects is going to preview forward 5 frames from the location of the playhead. So if you need to match stuff to the audio preview, this is a good way to do it. But now we want to give our full attention to the preview panel. So I'll make sure nothing is selected, and then I'll click on the word preview and show you the preview panel in its full glory. The first thing that I want you to see is this reset option. You can click on it to reset all of those 7 different shortcuts that you have. So this means that now we are back to the factory defaults. And each one of them is going to change the things that we are seeing underneath. So for example, if I'm going to switch to Shift plus Numpad 0, you can see that After Effects is going to skip 1 frame when I'm going to hold, of course, the Shift and press on 0 in the numpad. Now, if you're using After Effects on a laptop and you don't have access to an extended keyboard, of course, you can modify each one of the different keyboard shortcuts. If you also want to return to the previous behavior, what is also known as the classic preview, what we used to have before CC, so CS6 and earlier, then you can hold down the Option or the Alt key and then click on this little guy, and this is going to reset it to the classic behavior, which is again going to change a few of the settings over here. In my case, I'm just going to reset it back to the current default settings and quickly go through the things that we are seeing here. So the first thing that we are seeing that if I'm going to press spacebar, we are going to include both the video and the audio, but we can also include the overlays. And this means that if I'll click on this thing and then select everything in my timeline, so I'm going to press Command A to select everything. And just for the sake of demonstration, so I won't compete with the audio, I'm going to take it off and start to preview by pressing spacebar. After Effects is going to show me all of the overlays while it's previewing. And if I'll press again the spacebar, it will pause. You can also play from the current time, meaning that if I'll take my cursor and place it over here and just press spacebar, since these are already green, those frames are going to just be played in real time. Then, of course, you have the option to change the frame rate, to skip frames, as well as change the resolution. You can also tick the full screen button. So let's just enable this and again go a little bit back and press spacebar. And as you can see, it's going to take your composition full screen until you press spacebar again. And over here, I'm just going to take this away. You can see that when I'm pressing spacebar again to stop, I can determine what will happen. So a lot of stuff that you can modify. I'm going to reset everything back to its default settings. And I'm also going to return to the timeline and press Command-Shift-A or Control-Shift-A or even better, F2 to deselect everything. So now we already saw it is taking a lot of time to preview this composition. I want to make it a bit more closer to real time. So first I'll go to the beginning. I'll press Control and Clear to purge all the cache. And then I'm going to switch to Shift plus Spacebar and change a few of the settings. So first I'm going to switch off the audio. I don't need it in this case. I can also ask After Effects to cache everything before playback, meaning that it will go through the composition and only when it is totally green, it will start to play it. So this is optional stuff, but if you want to make sure that you are seeing everything in real time, you can switch this option on. In this case, I'm going to change the resolution to half and maybe also skip one frame. And only by changing these two settings, if I'll press the shift and spacebar combination again, you can see that I'm getting very close, if not real-time playback of the same composition, which should be good enough for me to judge if everything is working according to my plan. And I think it does. So I'll pause the playback. And you can see that while After Effects is pausing, it's going to switch back to the full quality. Before I'll say goodbye, I'm going to press the numpad 0 to preview this composition in full screen, as well as maximize the configure to show you how it looks. And this concludes this tutorial about the preview panel in After Effects. Of course, this is not the end of the story. There are more stuff that you can do to make things move faster in After Effects, such as change the layer and the comp quality, but I'm saving these tips for the next video. But this is it for this time. If you like this video, please click on the like button, maybe also the subscribe and the bell icon. And I think this is going to be a great time to do it right now. Anyhow, I want to thank you again for watching, and I hope to see you very soon in the next tutorial.